there was one more bridge to cross on the road to the Final Four. The maroon and white fans who made the trek north sensed what was at stake. The pre-game pep rally set the stage for an even greater celebration to come. Cincinnati brought a tough-talking, tough-walking bunch of Bearcats to Lexington. Seeded number two in the tournament, they boasted a 28-4 record coming into the game with Mississippi State. The Bearcats, playing solid basketball, thought they were ready for anything. However, the experienced tournament tough club found out very early that Bulldogs and Bearcats don't mix. Once again, the Bulldogs came out of the block smoking. Dante Jones picked up where he left off in the first game, scoring the Dogs' first points with a hesitating jump shot. In less than a minute, he added a three-pointer to set in motion a team that had a vision. A vision that came more clearly into focus as the game progressed.
Gets it back, gives it to Darrell Wilson, out to Jones. Free-throw line jumper, home. Dante Jones, free-throw line jumper, has been a one-man scoring machine for Mississippi State. He has scored.
By the time the first television timeout occurred, the Dogs had a commanding 9-point lead. Every time the Bearcats made a move, the Bulldogs countered. From the tall to the short, each man played his role to lead the Dogs to an 8-point lead at the half. Dante's 7-for-11 from the floor contributed to MSU's impressive 56% field goal average in the first half. The Bulldogs were just 20 minutes away from history. It would take the broad shoulders of Eric Dampier, the legs of the leaper, and the hard-nosed play of MSU's point guard, who has many of the characteristics of an NFL linebacker when the chips are down.
Bulldogs play the perimeter again. Bullard penetrates into the lane. Bullard with a jumper is good. We've got a foul on the floor. Boys, a good job. He just drove it in the middle. And a contact by Legree as he took the shot. And the Bulldogs take a 7-point lead, and Bullard will have an opportunity at a 3-point.
When help was needed, it came in the form of Tyrone Washington, Whit Hughes, and Bart Heitch, three men who have all year long accepted their roles and quietly contributed significantly to the Bulldogs' success. The final chapter of the Southeast Regional was like a magnificent dance, choreographed by a master and brilliantly performed by his cast, who complemented each other with strength, speed, and finesse.
Ice will work against pressure down, and Bart begins to dribble it and move it around, and Cincinnati is not going to chase it. This basketball game is over. Mississippi State's on the way to the Final Four with a 10-point win over the Cincinnati Bearcats. And the Bulldogs all in the center of Rupp Arena, hugging one another and double off the floor. A little bit of all of it.
Well, it's a great opportunity for Mississippi State in sports.
Dante Jones was unanimously named Most Valuable Player, with Eric Dampier and Darrell Wilson receiving honors on the All-Tournament team. The Bulldogs of 96 had accomplished what no other team in Mississippi State history had done. Most games played. Most victories in a single season. The most points in a single season. The first team in school history to reach the national championship finals, the Final Four. In a span of 2 weeks, Mississippi State had defeated three top 10 teams on a neutral court. It seems like everyone just played a terrible game against the Bulldogs. Some of the top teams in the country could manage to shoot only around 30% against the Dogs. Is there a pattern here? We think so. There is a new name to add to Lexington and Indianapolis. It's called Starkville. It's where the Bulldogs live. And when the Road Warriors return, fans of all ages pack the Golden Triangle Regional Airport to express their joy and pride in what this team had accomplished.